there. Thanks for tuning in. Torgo with Torgo Entertainment here. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. Welcome back to another gig log. This marks the first Torgo Entertainment gig log of 2021.
Running. She's running, and running, and running, and running, and running, and really, really running.
Thank you.
Full disclosure right out the gate, I did film the intro and outro for this gig log in my house, in my office, but I didn't really like how it turned out, so I decided to redo it on the fly right here. Plus, it's looking really misty outside. Kind of looks like the overworld from Final Fantasy IX a little bit, one of my favorite games of all time. So let's put in some appropriate music and make that happen. Today, we head to the Arnott Mall in Big Flats, New York. We've been there before. We had a gig log last year, the first gig log of last year. But this time we go for an indoor 5K courtesy of the Southern Tier Running Club. One or two of the members of the Southern Tier Running Club have followed me throughout the years in my various trivia excursions that I've had in the Twin Tiers, and they reached out to me, not through Torgo Entertainment, on my personal social media, and my friend Jenny was like, hey, you know, we're having this indoor 5K on Sunday, and we're looking for people to monitor the doors and make sure that mall shoppers aren't going to enter the mall and interrupt people during their 5K. Would you like to volunteer and do that? And I said, no, but I tell you what I will do. I was more than willing to provide music for this event for a couple different reasons. Number one, it gives me an opportunity to have Phil work, and it gives me an opportunity to have Andy work. Andy, who you've seen in my top 20 best and worst hit songs of 2020 video, he has wanted to do some stuff with me for Torgo Entertainment, but the opportunity never came up, especially last year with COVID and whatnot going on. So this is a nice simple gig. It gives him a good chance to learn how to set up the equipment, take down the equipment. And secondly, I'm testing out some new gear today. This will be the test of my brand new subwoofer that I got. You're probably going to say goodbye to the Electro Voice ZXA1 subwoofers. They work perfectly fine and I love them dearly. But during the springtime, when I like to go to all the different wedding venues I have throughout the year that I've never played at before, I feel that's an important part of the job, you know. When you're playing someplace you've never been, going in blind is a nightmare. So I always go well ahead of time to scout it out. Where am I gonna load in? Where are the power outlets? Stuff like that. But I noticed a couple of the venues are quite large this year, and I know that my current speaker setup, while perfectly functional, isn't quite gonna cut it. I'm gonna have to upgrade to probably 15-inch tops, which I haven't done yet. But the subwoofer has to be upgraded as well. And I found a really nice deal on Facebook Marketplace for the good old JBL SRX 828 SP, the double cabinet 18-inch subwoofer. DJ Barr uses it now in his videos. That's not why I got it. I'm a little hesitant with people climbing on it and dancing on it. But upon hearing it compared to other options, it sounded really good. And this guy was selling it for $500 off the retail price, so I really couldn't go wrong. So Andy and I went and got that about 3 or 4 weeks ago. The only problem is the man was selling it from Deal, Maryland. Here's a map to show you where Deal, Maryland is, and good gracious, 5 hours away. And I was gonna move to Annapolis for a hot minute in 2016, so I was very familiar with that drive. So it wasn't really a problem, just kinda had to suck it up and do it. But we did it, and it was a good time. I didn't get any footage of that because that's literally just driving down and back, and it was in the middle of the night. Nothing was gonna come from that, unfortunately. But that's gonna work, and I know that the Arnott Mall has very tall ceilings where we're going to be, like 50 feet tall. So this would be a great time to test the subwoofer. I can't exactly test it in my house without angering my neighbors or blowing out a window. So I figured this was the best chance to do it. I'm quite excited for this one. I get to do a lot more upbeat music and a lot more freeform music than I normally do. I get to play some of the EDM that's come out in the past couple months. I've been really loving some of the promo-only discs that have been coming out for the dance radio. I get to do a lot more of the harder edge rock that I don't normally get to do. So it's a good time with that new music. I get to, you know, try out new things when the pressure isn't on as much for a wedding. Where is the Arnott Mall, in case you forgot? Let's take a look at the map. So we're looking at about a 15-minute drive. As you can obviously tell, it's raining. That's a bit of a concern of mine. You have people running an indoor 5K. I know that that tile floor in the mall is very slippery, so I'm not quite sure how that's gonna work out. But we gotta make it through. But with the rain, it's going to take about 20 minutes. Something I learned when I had my old engineering job back in 2011 when I was doing some soil testing on construction sites. Yeah, I've had a pretty colorful life. You go the speed limit. If it's raining, you go 5 under. If it's nighttime, you go 5 under. If it's snowing, you go 10 under. Stack accordingly. And I like to think of myself as a safe driver, so keep that in mind, especially if you're carrying heavy gear. And account accordingly for your time. I hope you're ready for this one. I don't often have 3 of us on a gig at one time, but I think it'll be a good time. It's not gonna be a very in-depth gig log. There's not gonna be dancing or anything, you know? So it's just gonna be photos and video of people running, but I hope you're ready for this one. I hope you get something out of it. Let's go. Illustrate how the load-in works for this particular event, I have here a top-down view of the Arnott Mall. I don't know if you can really tell this, but this was actually the largest shopping mall on the Eastern Seaboard at one point in time. Let me overlay a graphic here, and that star icon is center court, and that's where we're going to be set up. Immediately to the north of that, that enclosed-looking area, that's the parking garage. We have the movie theater on top of that, and that's where we can load in and out, which is very handy, especially given the inclement weather. That path surrounding us is the path that the runners are going to take. Now they have 4 heats, one from 7 to 8 a.m., one from 8 to 9, one from 9 to 10, and one from 10 to 11. Maximum of 25 people per heat. And they're going to start immediately to the north of us, kind of where that teal icon is. And they're going to move in a counterclockwise fashion for 5 laps. 5 laps makes 5 kilometers, or at least close enough for this particular event. So because we have to have music going in both directions, I have 2 speakers facing behind me and 2 speakers facing in front. On the bottom, we have the JBL SRX 828SP. This thing is a monster. I love the way it sounded in here. We have the Bose S1 Pro speakers facing in front, the QSC K10.2s behind. I know it looks a little goofy, but it sounded better with this orientation. We have some speaker stands, the light-up ones from ADJ on the inside, just some regular ones on the outside, with some ADJ Element Hex PARs underneath. That's preset color number 12. You can see we have the 10-inch speakers going behind because it's a higher altitude from where we are, and it just projects better. I didn't want to blare out the people directly in front of us. My anti-fatigue mat is here. We have the Allendale Defender to hide some cords. We still have to tape a little bit of stuff down. And my Pioneer DDJ SX2 controller, as you've seen so many times on this channel. My Samsung Odyssey Notebook running Virtual DJ Pro. Look at those color-coordinated songs. We have people getting ready to run. Trackball mouse, my Audio-Technica MX50 headphones, and the mic rack, which we ended up not needing. That's everything we need to have for today.
Oh,
So that turned out pretty well. I can't tell you how much of a sick little joy it is for me to play songs that are kind of related to racing that only I know fit, like something from Sonic the Hedgehog, the Mario Starman theme, the Chariots of Fire theme, although one person did catch on to the Vangelis. I was very pleased about that. Overall, again, not very much to say about this gig. I hope it is dynamic enough for you, and I hope it's interesting to see me do something besides a wedding or a school dance. I do have some school dances coming up this year. 2021 is looking crazy. I just booked a wedding today, so that means I have 20 weddings lined up for this year. It looks like we might have some bounce back, and I'm a little concerned. Let me know in the comments if this applies to you as well. Not everything is fully open, so my issue that I foresee is once that switch is thrown and everyone's going to want everything all at once, I worry about being absolutely buried. I worry about turning away a lot of work. And I also kind of worry about people who are less expensive than me getting a lot of the work. I feel like some people are going to be seriously price shopping, especially when so many potential clients have been out of work for so long. As always, a playlist is left at the tail end of this video. What worked for me may not work for you, but hopefully you get some use out of it. Maybe you'll get inspired to play some stuff that you don't normally play. But I'm Torgo with Torgo Entertainment. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you at the next gig. Take care. Thank you.